Welcome to the April Sings a Lot podcast, where I share a story, a song, and invite you to sing along. This is my story. This is my song. Our toddler Henry is in that really fun stage where he thinks everything is his and mine. Seems to be his favorite word. I know it's just a phase. I'm trying to roll with the punches here. But it is a bit frustrating. And we had a great example of that frustration over the weekend. Henry is loving playing with cars. And so he has plenty of those little matchbox cars and other vehicles of varying shapes and sizes that he runs all over the house. And, you know, they're meant for kids to play with, and so there's no real damage done. You know, the most tragic thing that might happen is they get lost under the couch or stuck under the fridge or something, but for the most part, they're indestructible, and he enjoys just slamming them into each other and making little racetracks and just having a good time with them. And then over the weekend, we were in my husband's office, and Henry looks up on one of the bookshelves, and he sees this extremely elaborate Lego crane that is way high up on a shelf. It's a display piece. It's not meant to be played with. And Henry says, "Mine? Mine?" And he wants that car, and he wants to play with it, and he would not let it go. So my husband very graciously got it down from the very top shelf that it was on and put batteries in it and showed off all the different exciting things that this elaborate Lego crane can do. But of course, Henry doesn't care about all of that. He just wants to run into things and slam things and be destructive because that's what toddlers enjoy. And that is not something that the Lego crane is meant to do. And so very quickly, the Lego crane went back to the top shelf and has not come back out to play. It reminded me of my own self, actually, because there are times when I think that I'm ready for something different than what I have. And in reality, those situations are like the Lego crane is for Henry, way too much for me to handle right now. So I would encourage you to maybe take that perspective when you're looking at things in your own life. Like, what are some ways that I can grow right now so that I can better handle the opportunities that are going to come my way? Because God is a great God, and He is so good to us. And everything that's happening in our lives right now is happening to prepare us for our future. I'd like to challenge you and challenge myself to enjoy where you are on the way to where you're going. If you're playing with matchbox cars in the kitchen, enjoy playing with matchbox cars in the kitchen instead of begging and pleading for a complicated Lego crane that you might not be ready for. Our song today is How Great Thou Art. It's one of my favorite songs. And I love that reminder that our God is a great God.
I hear the rolling thunder. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great. Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it. That on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
All right, that concludes another episode. Thank you so much for listening. If you would like to find out about new episodes and receive other extras, sign up for emails at aprilsingsalot.com and you'll be in the loop whenever something new comes out.